Hi, I'm Kayla, and here at the garden, we are talking about how we overwinter honeybees. With some of our native bees, they will lay eggs in protected cavities, such as a hollowed out stick, for example, and then those eggs will be protected and be able to overwinter, but the adult will die off. Some of our other native bees will also hibernate over winter, but honeybees, they do neither. They actually remain a fully functioning colony throughout the winter. They don't actually hibernate and they don't die off. They just cluster together and try to keep each other really, really warm. Actually, you can see behind me, we're in the middle of January and our bees are still active and thriving even.
In the wintertime when you can't open the hive, if it was really cold today and we wanted to see if the bees were alive and how large the cluster was, we could use an infrared camera to do that. So infrared cameras have different color schemes. The one that we like to use, the cooler temperatures are going to be blue and purple. The warmer temperatures, you're going to get into the orange and yellow and then red. So you see all the heat up here?
That's where they're at. There's a little fireball. The other important thing is making sure that they are as pest and disease free as possible. Back at the very end of summer and beginning of fall, we started our preparation for overwintering the hives. And that entailed testing for mites and treating if necessary for high mite counts. Unfortunately, they'll never be truly pest or disease free around here. But we want to make sure that they have as low of a mite count as possible going into winter, because that'll just increase their chances of survival by so much more if they don't have a lot of extra pests and diseases to worry about. So this here is a solid candy board. It's basically just solidified sugar, and we use this to feed the bees during the colder times of the year, so during the winter. The reason we would supplementally feed bees is because we don't want them to run out of food stores with their natural honey. And also with this in particular, this solid candy board, it's a really good moisture absorber. If you find you're not going to require supplemental feeding, one thing you can do to help reduce moisture in the hive is use this exact same board, minus the candy part, but just the board and the mesh, and you can put wood chips in it and put that on top of your hive. And these wood chips here are great at absorbing moisture and cutting down moisture in your hive. When you see a bee out and about during winter, they might find a little bit of pollen and a little bit of nectar through witch hazel, which is in bloom right now. It's actually the first Missouri native plant to bloom in the year. But in reality, there's not a whole lot for them out there to forage. It's more or less for them to stretch their legs.
Honeybees are really important organisms for all of us because they are a primary pollinator for a lot of our agricultural crops. Some of our, fruits that we enjoy every June are in our store thanks to them, because they have pollinated those plants. But just as important as honeybees, we also have to take a look at our native bees as well. They are also pollinating all around all of our native plants, all the flowers that we enjoy for the spring. And sometimes they don't get noticed as much, but they are still a part of our whole ecosystem. And I encourage people to also pay attention to them as well, because they are such an important part of why we have plants and how we can enjoy flowers every year.